Welcome to the great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael, I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And our topic today is one leg in the world. Many people do not realize that they cannot serve two masters. They believe that they can continue in the world and at the same time have eternal salvation in heaven. But they stand with one leg in the world and with one leg in heaven. They proclaim to be a true son of Jesus Christ and a follower of Jesus Christ and a true believer. But at the same time, they stand with one leg in the world and continue in partying, in drinking, in smoking, in their careers, following for money, in their riches, and everything that the world offers. They go for holidays, they go for all things, and when they see something where they are required by the heavenly Lord to help needy or ministries, they just reject them. Just say, we don't have money. But they spend money for games like Xbox, for TVs, for cars, for holidays, for drinking, for partying. There they have money. When it comes to heavenly things, suddenly they have no money. These people are lukewarm because they have one leg in the world and one leg in heaven. This is the Church of Laodicea. All the people who are still believing that they can continue in their old ways in the world and still have eternal life are completely mistaken. Jesus said to the rich man, sell everything what you have and give it to the poor. And then take your cross and follow me. So he had to give everything away from the world that bound him to the world. And then he could come out. And then he could walk with Jesus. Not before. Jesus has taken the apostles away from their jobs. They were fishermen. But they were removed from their jobs. Because if they remain in their jobs, in their careers, they would have one leg in the world and one leg with Jesus. That was impossible. They had to use both legs and place them into heaven. And that is exactly what you also have to do. Over the next few days, I will make a series, a teaching series about how you can separate yourself from the world. Because there are people who have asked me, how do you separate yourself from the world? It is not so difficult than you think. You can separate yourself from the world through establishing of a dwelling place of Zion in your home. It does not need to be big. It just needs your commitment, your prayers, your repentance and your obedience to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So come out of the world and out of Babylon. Babylon is a Jezebel spirit of idolatry, the false teachers, the false churches, the lukewarm churches. Come out. Remember, you cannot serve two masters. Jesus was himself. He said that you cannot serve two masters. But this is what you are doing right now. You are trying to balance the world and the heaven. But instead to balance them correctly, what you do is you have one leg in the world, in excess, and one leg in heaven. And then you are lukewarm. On one side in heaven you are very hot, but on the side of the world you are very cold. And you can see that. Just look at yourself in the mirror and ask yourself what you do. When you see homeless people, what you do when Michael comes and asks you to help and so into the ministry? What do you do when you see children in need? What do you do when you see the needy? I tell you what you do. You turn your back and you say, oh, somebody else can help. We do not have the money. But then the next step will guide you into a supermarket where you buy excess food for $150. So you have funds, you have resources, but you are not willing to share them. Read the the book of Acts chapter 2, where you can see that the two Christians were coming together and they shared their resources and laid them at the apostles' feet so that the funds will be available for the needy and for the poor, to help the widow and the children and the afflicted. Now, if I come to you and ask you to help with the children in Cambodia, then you tell me I'm a fake person, and you tell me I'm a scammer, and you tell me whatever. You tell me I'm a liar. Do you know me? Be very, very, very careful that you do not act against the Holy Spirit. And be very careful, because we remember the story in the Bible that people have entertained angels unaware. Be very careful what you say, and very careful what you do. It might cost you your eternal life. So please, come out of the world and enter the heavenly realm with both legs. Do something for the needy. Help. Help us in our mission to Cambodia. Join us. Walk with us the path to Mount Zion, to the holy mountain. Be part of the multitude clothed in white that will be raptured into paradise at the sixth seal. This is your time to step out and to separate yourself from the world. Thank you that you have listened to this topic today, and I hope that you consider your ways, and I hope that you will help us in our mission to Cambodia. The links are in the description box below and also in the first pinned comment. Thank you for your help, for your understanding, and thank you that you will come again tomorrow. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.